Starlings by Amy Thompson. Amy states, "My inspiration for this piece really came after applying the first layer of leafing. Where I live, I have lots of birds. So I began to try and find what kind they were, and I came across the starling. Often seen as disruptive, aggressive birds with an ugly call, dull color in the winter, but in the summer, they turn a sparkling, glossy wonder. I began to leaf one piece over another, gold, silver, and copper. A bright, beautiful plumage that is quite stunning. We are all changing from season to season, like the starling. We shine, we dull, we molt, like the starling."
I fell in love with the juxtaposition and the mood of the painting starlings. There's such power in the subtlety of the work. There's confidence in the softness, and I appreciate that the muted colors are quiet yet reflective. And there's a metallic tone, but there's also a shyness in the work. And the shapes are melted and layered in the seemingly random way, but it's perfect. And I knew when creating the work for Flux, I wanted to focus on layering, repetition, and relationships. So I sought to create physical and visual conversations between the music and the dancers, between the dancers and the audience, and amongst the dancers themselves. I hope that you enjoy the piece, and I'm very proud to work with the young artists of Flux Dance Company. Enjoy.
Thank you.
Let Me Out by Carrie Hubert was inspired by a time in her life when she was looking for redirection. She said it was inspired by hope, healing, and love.
The mystery behind the woman in the painting inspired me to reach within and discover what parts of myself are seen by others and what parts are hidden deep within. The struggle to discover and accept one's true self is a journey we must all take.
Melt My Face was created by Thomas Kleber in the winter of 2020. Tom says he used his creativity as a way to adapt during the pandemic. This creation started off with the use of red and yellow colors. Tom joked that he was going to call the painting Ketchup and Mustard because that's exactly what it looked like. But as the painting began to transform, Tom saw images and shapes that looked like flames. So from there, he used the technique called stippling, where he uses little tiny dots to add dimension into his painting. And from there, it turned into Melt My Face. If you've ever tried the stippling technique, Tom says it can be very strenuous on the eyes as well as the hands. And so not only did the painting look like flames and fire, but it also felt like fire. So a play on words there by Thomas Kleber.
I was really intrigued by the artist's use of abstract shapes that seem to fuse and fold into each other in juxtaposition to the more linear slashes that intersect and feel more rigorous and structured. This inspired me to create moments of ease and fluidity in contrast to movements that are much more abrupt in quality. In addition to my visual perceptions, the title Melt My Face helped me develop conceptual motifs of influence, reliance, and ultimately evolving into one unit that only functions in the presence of all components.
Where Is My Mind was created by Carrie Hubert. Carrie said she was inspired during a period of her life where she was finding new direction. She was going through a period of healing and was most inspired by love, healing, and hope.
I have chosen the artwork Where Is My Mind because I love the simplicity of the painting compared to all the others, and I think just by looking at the piece, you can interpret and create whatever you felt. The title can also be interpreted into different types of meanings depending on how you feel while looking at this painting. I have made the stance with this artwork completely towards the title because I wanted to show how different people's minds have been lately after everything that has happened in the society today and how people have changed the way their mind is just by how the environment is around them. While there are still some people that are trying to help others get them out of struggling state of mind to try and change them for a better, but while helping them, it is hard nowadays to do that because sometimes you get dragged down with them and feel lost on your own.
Thank you. Day's End, created by Sandy Weinhold, was inspired by the most beautiful and captivating sunset Sandy had seen. Sandy says she's inspired by color, and the colors in that sunset sucked her right in. She said in the moment, the only thing she could focus on was the feeling of joy, peace, and the beautiful colors of that sunset. Sandy hoped to recreate that image as well as that feeling with her painting, Day's End.
When a time in our life comes to an end, we can struggle to create new beginnings. We move forward, continuing to build our lives piece by piece with the memories of the life we once lived and the memories we are about to create. When a day ends too soon, find peace in the sunset, find peace in the memories, and know you are strong enough to rebuild.
Jealous of the rain that falls upon your skin, it's closer than my hands have been. Oh, I'm jealous of the rain. I'm jealous of the wind that ripples through your clothes. It's closer than your shadow. Oh, I'm jealous of the wind. 'Cause I wished you the best of all this world could give, and I told you when you left me, there's nothing to forgive. But I always thought you'd come back. Tell me, all you found was heartbreak and misery. It's hard for me to say I'm jealous of the way you're happy without me. As I sink in the sand and I watch you slip through my hands, oh, as I die here another day, babe, 'cause all I do is cry behind the smile. I wish you the best of all this world could give, and I told you when you left me, there's nothing to forgive. But I always thought you'd come back. Tell me, all you found was heartbreak and misery. And it's hard for me to say I'm jealous of the way you're happy without me. And it's hard for me to say I'm jealous of the way you're happy without me. And it's hard for me to say I'm jealous of the way you're happy without. You're happy without me.
Connectivity by Thomas Kleber. Tom says this piece was inspired by a much smaller piece where he used the same stippling technique. He was inspired to take it to a much larger scale, and so he began working on what he calls connectivity. This was created during the COVID pandemic, so he was stuck in the house. He was unable to be around friends and family, and so he turned to his art. as he began to create this piece, the visuals of the interwoven lines took on a whole new meaning. The depth of it spoke to him, and in all those little lines, he knew somehow they were all connected, yet somehow they were not. And that is how Tom created connectivity.
When presented with this concept of being able to bring two different types of artistry together, I was really exhilarated. Immediately, I was drawn to this picture called connectivity, and I could really see the intricacies of the way that the picture intertwined and interacted with itself, and I could envision bodies in motion bringing this to life. The way that the bodies could physically interact with each other, the way that they could interact with the negative space around each other, and also just the concept of connecting with other human bodies emotionally, and the way that I could bring that to life was really, really exciting. And I really hope you enjoy this.
When the War Drum Sounds was inspired by a time in my life when I was learning how to paint and intuitively paint. And by that, I mean just not really thinking about the painting process, but just picking up the paintbrush and going with what feels right. At the time, I was finding a lot of symbolism in my life, a lot of spirituality, and I was influenced by the Native American culture and tradition. And one of the things was I loved listening to the drumming music, and the feeling I got from that painting, or what was happening when I was painting, was just the intense feeling of when you are being called in life or in certain situations. When you are being called, you go, you show up, and you do your work.
As a choreographer, I couldn't wait to bring this work of art to life on stage. The dancers were just as excited as I was to create this piece. Right away, the bright colors and warlike energy reminded me of a musical we all know and love, Hairspray. The bright colors of the artwork matching the bright colors of the dresses in the 60s, the warlike beating of drums fighting for equality and freedom of expression. We all had an absolute blast creating this piece, and we hope you have just as much fun watching.